In this video, we like to show you how we build our cheese press. For projects like this, I always try to find some leftover pieces of wood and whatever else I need in my shop. So it's good to keep everything, if you have enough space. The basic plate is made of 3/4 inch plywood. I decide to build it in this size because of it fits perfect to the drain pan I found in the store. You can make it bigger or smaller, whatever you like. So this size is perfect for 6 pieces of round cheese by 4 inch, or for 2 pieces of cheese round by 6 inch. I tried to make the whole cheese press pretty solid because of you never know what happened in the future, and if you like to make different kind of cheese you need different pressures. For cheddar cheese the pressure is not so high than if you like to make some Parmesan cheese. Both of the vertical stands are made out of 2x6, same thing with the crossbar on top, so the horizontal crossbar is made out of 2x6 too. I mark that vertical stands on the basic plate and I glue them on, and I used a couple screws to make sure they are strong and tight together with the basic plate. There is one thing I learned in my life. It's better you make it stronger. It can never be strong enough. So in this case, better put one more screw in than one not enough. Then I put the horizontal header on. I pre-drilled the holes for the pneumatic cylinder. I pre-drilled the holes for the screws because of I don't want that the wood splits if I screw the screws in. Four screws on both sides should be enough to hold the pressure. Two vertical braces, one on each side, should make the head part very, very strong. They are maybe not necessary, but I like to put them on. I used the DeWalt drill hammer to move them pieces in place before I screw them on. That's it, and the cheese press base is done. For the press force, I used that 40 millimeter pneumatic cylinder that I found in my shop. The working way of this pneumatic cylinder is plus minus 250 millimeters, what's the equivalent to 10 inch. Now it's time to put the 4-2 weigh valve onto the frame from the cheese press. It's simple to connect that hoses with that pneumatic quick couplers. a small zip tie to tie the hose to the cylinder. Connected to the pressure air that comes from the compressor. If you turn it on, the cylinder comes out, and if you switch it off, the cylinder goes back in. Here you can see how we make the parts for the cheese molds. I made them out of cutting boards that I bought at the dollar store. It's the cheapest way if you need a piece of plastic and you can't find anything else. Thank you. That's a simple PVC coupling 4-inch and a 4-inch drain cap. And that's are the round plates I made. I use them as a press plate. I also cut 6 pieces of ABC 2-inch pipe as a space holder for the cheese press. You can simply adjust the pressure for the cheese press by turning the handle of your pressure regulator at your compressor. And that's our first try to make cheddar cheese with our homemade pneumatic cheese press. If you like to know more about how we made goat cheese and what different varieties we made, follow us on our YouTube channel. Thanks guys for watching this video, and we hope we see you soon.